Hello everyone, I am K.R. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, WIT Solapur. Welcome to a video lecture on types of discrete time signals. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this session, students will be able to know different ways of representing discrete time signals, classify various forms of discrete time signals. These are the sum of the contents. Start with the representation of discrete time signals, basic types of discrete time signals, and references. Representation of discrete time signals. There are four different forms of representing discrete time signals. They are graphical representation, functional representation, tabular representation, sequence representation. Representation of above four methods are explained by taking one example each. Consider a signal x of n with values x of minus 2 is equal to minus 3, x of minus 1 is equal to 2, x of 0 equal to 0, x of 1 is equal to 3, x of 2 is equal to 1, so on. So different values of n, which varies from minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and corresponding value of x of n, minus 3, 2, 0, 3, 1, 2, are represented using first method, graphical method. Along the x-axis, you need to consider the values of n, which varies from minus 2 to plus 3. Along the y-axis, you need to take the values of n. Every value of n, that is, for example, minus 2, the corresponding value of x of n. Similarly, n is equal to minus 1, corresponding value of x of n will be 2. Similarly, at 0, it is a separation or origin of this sequence. At n equal to 0, its x of n is 0, so on. So, second method of representation is functional representation. In functional representation, x of n, minus 3, 2, 0, 3, 1, 2, and corresponding value of n. For n is equal to minus 2, its value is minus 3. N equal to minus 1, its value is 2. So, the corresponding different values of n, the corresponding value of x of n will be given. Next is tabular representation. In tabular representation, we need to consider n in first row and x of n in second row. So, different values of n, the corresponding value of x of n will be representation. Next one is sequence representation. A finite duration sequence can be represented as x of n is equal to minus 3, 2, 0, 3, 1, 2. This arrow indicates that is origin of the signal. So towards right are called the that is n equal to 1, 2. Towards left is called the n equal to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. This is a sequence representation. Recall what are the different methods of continuous time signals we have seen. Pause this video for a moment and think of what are the different types of continuous time signals. The different types of continuous time signals are, start with the step signal and ramp signal, parabolic signal, etc. The same signals we are going to study using discrete time signals. The basic types of discrete time signal. First one is unit step signal. So unit step signal will be represented by u of n, and it is defined as u of n is equal to 1 for n is greater than or equal to 0, 0 for n less than 0. So this is a sequence. You can see that is along the x-axis it is n corresponding u of n. Okay, we have different values of n corresponding value of u of n. So n equal to 0, that is 1, n equal to 1, also 1. And this varies from, n varies from 0 to plus infinity, its values are 1. But whereas in the negative side, you don't find any signals. That because n is less than 0, its value is 0. Next one is unit ramp signal. Unit ramp sequence will be represented by r of n, and it is defined as r of n is equal to 1 for n is greater than or equal to 0. 0 for n is less than 0. You can see this graph, okay, along the x-axis we need to consider n, along the y-axis is r of n. For different values of n, the corresponding r of n will be written. So if, for example, if I substitute n equal to 0, its value is 0 only at origin. If I substitute n equal to 1, so r of 1 is equal to 1, that is first sequence is amplitude equal to 1. Similarly, if I substitute n equal to 2, r of 2 is equal to 2. You can see the second sample. Similarly, n equal to 3, then r of 3 is equal to 3. Keep on, that varies from 0 to plus infinity. Whereas in the negative side, n is less than 0, its value is 0. We need not consider that is not negative side, only positive side, which varies from 0 to plus infinity, samples will be present. Next one is a unit impulse sequence. The unit impulse sequence will be represented by delta n. It's very simple. Delta n can be defined as its existence only exists only at n equal to 0, otherwise its value is 0. We can see this graph along the x-axis. You can see that is n varies from minus infinity to plus infinity. Its value is 0. So all other places except at n equal to 0. So this type of signal is delta n. This can be used for that is nothing but many applications in digital signal processing. Next, unit parabolic function. Unit parabolic function is represented by p of n. Discrete time parabolic function is defined as p of n is equal to n square by 2 for n is greater than or equal to 0, 0 for n is less than 0. In terms of step function, it can be written as p of n is equal to n square by 2 into u of n. This is the relation between unit parabolic function and the step function. P of n is equal to n square by 2 into u of n. Along the x-axis, you can see its value of n. Along the y-axis is a p of n. The different values of n we have considered 0 to plus infinity. This side is 0 to minus infinity. We are not looking for any that is n which varies from minus 1 to minus infinity because its value is 0. Whereas for plus side, it is if I substitute n equal to 0, it's 0 by 0, it's amplitude 0. If I substitute n equal to 1, that is 1 by 2, 0.5. If I substitute n equal to 2, that is 4 square. 2 square means 4, 4 divided by 2 is 2. So this is a signal for unit parabolic function. This is the relationship between parabolic and the unit step function. Next one is sinusoidal signal. The discrete time sinusoidal sequence is given by x of n is equal to a sine omega n plus pi, where a is the amplitude, omega is the angular frequency, and pi is the phase in angle in radians. You can see this graph along a discrete time signal, that is a which represents a sine omega n pi. Note, for a discrete time signal to be periodic, the angular frequency omega must be a rational multiple of 2 pi. The time period of the discrete time sinusoidal signal is given by n is equal to 2 pi m divided by omega. You can calculate that is the time period for a discrete time signal using this formula, where n is an integer. So next, discrete exponential signal. A discrete exponential signal is defined as x of n is equal to a raised to n for all n. So you can see this, x of n is equal to a raised to n. Here, first two graphs which varies from, that is nothing but, this a is greater than 1. You can see this, there is a graph which growing exponentially. If way varies from 0 to 1, if it is a graph or samples which decaying exponentially. Similarly, if a is less than minus 1, okay, a is less than minus 1, you can see that is alternatively samples are switching from plus to minus. So this is a is between minus 1 to 0. This is a case that is same thing as it is decaying, switching the samples alternatively. These are the same references I have considered. Thank you.